This video gives an introduction to the PhD research project titled Supporting Disaster Management Utilizing Multi-Agency Sensor Information, conducted as part of the Center for Disaster Management and Public Safety at the University of Melbourne. Rapid onset disasters, such as urban flooding, gives us a very short period of warning and response time. Several agencies who might or might not be established organizations in disaster management are committed to contribute and actively participate during emergency situations. To conduct efficient and effective disaster decision-making, during emergency situations, disaster-involved organizations need to get access and share up-to-date and timely disaster information. Among diverse types of disaster-aiding resources, sensors turn into a very important data-gathering technology. During the recent years, organizations have independently deployed various types of sensor systems within urban areas. The emphasis of this research is to study the process of access, exchange, and usage of these organizational sensor resources within emergency management sector. As part of the research, we conducted a case study on Victorian State of Australia to understand the current practices of sensor data provision within emergency management sector. We collected data on how disaster-involved organizations internally manage their sensor resources and how these sensor resources are externally exchanged between these organizations and then utilized for emergency management. As a result of this case study, we identified a number of interconnected issues. First, since organizations mostly rely on proprietary formats and standards such as RATEX data, binary data, and different XML variants, interoperable access to the data remains problematic. Second, this multi-source and non-interoperable sensor data is accompanied with different sources of inconsistencies. For this reason, when the data is shared, many informative elements in the feeds cannot be automatically harvested. Third, when the feeds reach emergency organization, they are stored on separated and detached data layers. As such, concurrent usage of sensor data from multiple sources is not adequately supported. In consequence of these issues, we have currently access to raw sensor data rather than actionable sensor information. To overcome these identified issues and requirements, we have developed a new framework for multi-vendor sensor information integration in support of cooperative disaster response. This framework is comprised of certain components, including sensor data standardization to enable homogeneous flow of sensor feeds between stakeholders, sensor data harmonization to automatically harvest incoming sensor feeds, integration data model to connect incoming sensor feeds into a unified data model, and finally, sensor web services to enable actual usage of this integrated sensor data within emergency situation. To improve the current practice, which is based on using proprietary sensor protocols, the first step is to define a common language to share sensor data between stakeholders. To achieve this, the research made use of OGC sensor web enablement standards, which are developed as defined standards for description and web-based access to sensor data. However, the challenge here is that these OGC SUI standards are designed in a rather generic manner to support different application domains. These standards are not designed for disaster management and not yet acknowledged in emergency management sector. To address this shortcoming, and as the objective of sensor data standardization component, a profile of current OGC SUI standards is designed to enable a standard-based exchange of sensor data between disaster-involved organizations. An overview of the design profile is shown in here. The profile consists of necessary elements for description of sensor metadata, sensor observations, and also the required operations for web-based access to the organizational sensor data. Once sensor data feeds, which are described based on the profile, reaches the emergency organization, there is a need to pre-process the feeds to make sure they are compliant with the profile, and then to automatically harvest various elements in the feeds, and finally to check if the feeds are compliant with the local repository at the recipient organization, otherwise harmonize the feeds. In here, the process chain of developed sensor data harmonization component is shown. There is a feeder in place that can pull sensor feeds, which are now standards and described based on sensor ML and observation and measurement encoding from the SOS servers deployed in the producer organization. Different elements within the feeds are retrieved, parsed, and then checked if they are compliant with the profile. Next, depending on if we are dealing with sensor ML files or observation and measurement files, the subsequent pre-processing steps for validity check and harmonization of the elements are called. Finally, the harmonized elements are stored on the database. Once we have a standard-based sharing of sensor data enabled between stakeholders and harmonizing the sensor feeds upon their arrival at the recipient emergency organization, the final step is to integrate these sensor feeds, which are coming from multiple sources, into a unified database model. To address this requirement, a database model called Integration Data Model Component is developed in this research. It collects data into a unified data store. It also establishes the relationship between framework data, which is static and already exists in the database, the sensors in which their information are coming as sensor ML files, and sensor observations, which are highly dynamic and their information are coming as a series of ONM files. The relationship between features are established using feature of interest as a common attribute between sensors and framework data, and sensor ID as a common attribute between sensors and their observations. Once we have a standard-based sharing, harmonization, and integration of sensor data enabled, actual delivery of sensor information to the end user is realized through developing a number of web services and a client application. An overall view of the framework is shown here. There is an SOS server deployed for each sensor data stakeholder. Produced sensor data is externally shared using the developed profile of sensor ML and observation and measurement standards. Upon arrival of sensor feeds at the recipient organization, they are validity checked, harmonized, and stored in the database, which uses the created database schema. The user can then use the client application to generate a query. The query request is processed by the associated sensor web service, which in turn consumes the unified data stored in the database. The query result is generated by the web service, returned and visualized on the client application.